Hello fellow NIMCNs and AMKNs. My name is Vikramjeet Bhayana and I'm from MB11, currently working at Bajaj Allianz General Insurance. I welcome you all to our very own visual podcast. How's the Josh? Let me invite our guest, Pooja ma'am. She is a happy, positive and a fun-loving person, born and brought up in an army household. Adapting to situations, people and circumstances come very easy to her as a result of upbringing. She got into the corporate sector post MBA, HR specialization, and she got her first job in GE Capital International Services in HR as a recruiter. Post GE, she joined Kotak Mahindra Life Insurance in Delhi. Thereafter, she got married and settled happily into family life with a loving husband and an adorable son. She took a break in her career, and after 7 years of marriage, tragedy struck and she lost her husband. With nowhere to fall back upon, she had to gather herself and her confidence again and restart her career. She joined Fab India within a month of her husband's passing away, and there has been no looking back since then. Thereafter, she moved to Max Healthcare and now with SpiceJet. She is currently looking after recruitment, HR business partner function, organization development, employee engagement, and L&D in SpiceJet. And only I have the rights to get free SpiceJet tickets. None of you, because I'm interviewing her. Each day is new and exciting, and she lives each day as it comes. Her mantra in life, be bold, be courageous, take risks, and never give up, as winter always turns into spring. What a wonderful thought, ma'am. Winter always turns into spring. Beautiful. Okay, with that, let's start with the Josh questions. Ma'am, are you a morning person or a night owl?
Completely morning person.
Lovely. And that resonates. You're radiating like the sunrise, ma'am. Absolutely.
Thank you so much. Thank you.
My next question, ma'am. Are you a coffee person or a tea person?
Coffee. Any day.
Lovely. I think there's a saying also, if you're a coffee person, you can never switch to tea, because the high, the content, the satisfaction that a coffee gives you, it can never be achieved in tea.
True.
Because I'm none, but this is what I've heard.
Yeah, true that.
My next question, ma'am, what's the first thing that you do when you wake up in the morning?
I thank God for all the blessings.
Lovely. What an honest thought. A lot of people, ma'am, would wake up and say that I check my phone, I check on WhatsApp. Of course, a lot of people do that, but such a pure way of starting your day to thank God for every day. Brilliant, man. Brilliant. Yes,
absolutely.
In this busy lifestyle, to take out that time also is critical. Not many people do that. They say, I'm very busy, how can I even thank God? But I think this is that you do first thing in the morning and it keeps you pure. Brilliant thought.
Actually, thank you.
My next question, ma'am, what's on your desk, your work desk?
My work desk, of course, has my laptop. My work desk will have my cell phone and a bottle of water, and otherwise it is ultra clean. I believe in no paper work desk.
Lovely. What are your thoughts, ma'am?
My laptop, the water bottle, and my mobile phone.
This actually resonates your thought process, ma'am. If your table is clutter free, I think thought process also clear. You're focused. You're not distracted by smaller things on the table. Oxygen is a necessity. It's become a part of our body. Water, you can't do without, and a laptop you need because it's a workstation.
Yeah.
Clutter free. Keep your desk clutter free, like ma'am is saying. It'll help you focus more, not get distracted, and have a healthier discussion in whatever you're doing. Perfect.
Yes, absolutely.
My next question, ma'am. What's on your smartphone home screen?
My own picture.
Wow. Love yourself first. I think that's very
cool. I love myself. I'm my own favorite.
Perfect. A lot of people forget that, man, that I think loving yourself is more critical, because only then you give out more, right?
And love others. Yes.
Absolutely. So I think having your photo on your phone, a lot of people say you shouldn't, but I somehow feel, and after speaking to man, I think it's a must. You can. There's nothing wrong in it, because if you can find yourself as your favorite, everything around you looks a lot more positive. So great.
Yeah, so because after thanking God for a bright new day, the first thing I do is look at my phone, and then I look at myself. As in, my phone has my picture.
What better than that?
It's a beautiful beginning to a great day.
Absolutely, ma'am. My next question to you, what's your favorite work day time waster?
To be really honest, I don't believe in wasting time at work. I'm a very organized person, so my entire day at work is very mischeduled. And where I've reached in my life, in my career, there are lots of meetings, and there are teammates, and there are feedbacks which are happening here and there. So I really don't believe in wasting time. I just have my morning coffee with and that too, it is my lunch is also a working lunch. So to be honest, I don't smoke, I don't chitter chatter and gossip around sitting with different people, because that leads to unnecessary politics. So you are in the corporate sector, you're aware. So I dedicate myself and keep myself focused to work and work only. While we have time zones and time, there are occasions when we have these employee engagement activities and other stuff, which are fun hours with team and interdepartment fun hours with team. Those are the only, but those are also scheduled and organized meetings.
Wow.
So there's really nowhere do I waste my time.
Brilliant. So I think one lesson from this is, if you're organized, you would know how to utilize every minute of your waking hour in office, and you would meet these fun time wasters, because there is already so much to do, right? And you
know
in it how that will go. So I think being organized really makes your day more productive, like you're saying, ma'am. I think that's
true. Last
question, ma'am. What's your favorite personal possession?
My favorite personal possession is I'll show it to you.
Sure.
This is this Aladdin ka chirag, which I got from Dubai, and I really love it. And somehow it's like the magic chirag, which a chirag which will fulfill my wishes. So I love to see it every day. I've kept it in my drawing room. It's not on my bedside table, but it's one of my favorite personal possessions. It's like the Aladdin of my life. Will just come out of it and fulfill all my wishes.
I think the good thing about this possession is, ma'am, it'll keep that wishes inside you alive. And I think it's very important to have wishes in life, because only then you will have a direction to walk towards them. If I don't for a particular thing, I will never work towards it. So I think instill that feeling of desire and drive in you. So I think even in the small thing that you are saying is your possession, I think it's a brilliant thing, because inner subconsciously keeps your wishes and dreams alive. I think
true. It's so important to have dreams.
True.
So I've put all my dreams in this, and one by one, when I open, they come out and they get fulfilled.
Lovely, ma'am. Lovely. I think that's everyone should also have a possession. And believe you me, like ma'am said, everything that you really like and you have has a meaning in it. You may not see it like in this lamp, not many people would see it like that, but I truly feel that she has a lot of wishes in life, and only because of that she is where she is today, because without them you can't be climbing the ladder.
That's what drives me. Yeah,
exactly. Lovely, ma'am. How do you run a meeting?
Okay, so like I said, I'm a very organized person. So I'm not the kind of a leader who likes to have ad hoc meetings. So my meetings are generally very planned, they're timely planned with an agenda. And of course, so that in fact, even in the meetings when I have my team together, we decide that it should not go haywire. We give timelines to people to speak. So the presentations have to be made in advance. The questions have to be made in advance. And since there are like 8 people or 10 people in the team, I give them a timeline that not more than you will get not more than 10 minutes to say what you have to say and describe what you need to describe. And then we move on to the next person. This ensures that the meetings are generally over within 2 to 3 hours. Otherwise, you can imagine the meetings can start in the morning at 9. And
they can go on and on.
Everything under the sun gets discussed, but work. So I like it to be very organized.
I think one interesting thing that you said, ma'am, giving people a stipulated time, because believe that if I cannot explain to you what I do in that time, then I'm not doing justice to what I'm supposed
exactly.
to
do.
If
exactly.
it's my job, I should be able to explain it to you in 1 minute sharp that this is what I do and this is what I want.
Yeah.
That shows clear, that shows clarity.
Preciseness is very important.
Exactly. Otherwise, you can keep beating around the bush and not.
The bush.
Agreed, ma'am. Great learning. My next question, ma'am, the one trait that you look for in new hires.
Okay, so I've always, you know, I started my journey as a recruiter, and I was with G Capital International Services, and I was trained to be a recruiter, a behavioral skills recruiter. So the first thing, and I've really believed to, you know, and to have this in my life, and also I've interviewed and hired some great people in my entire 20 years career. The basic thing which I, apart from the technical and other skills, one most important thing which I look in a person is attitude. So my mantra has been hire for attitude, train for skills.
Lovely.
Always. And more than an attitude, now you will say, you know, how can you judge an attitude of a person in a half an hour or 40 minute interview? Yeah. So there are lots of ways of doing that. So let's not get into that because that's a deeper discussion. So in attitude, what really impresses me the most is passion for excellence.
Correct.
And in whatever it may be, somebody has been passionate about a sports in college or school is good enough.
That's good
or
enough.
Maybe so you know, passion is very important for people to have in their life because that is what keeps on driving them to do better. Skills we can always teach.
Absolutely. There's no rocket science at job, ma'am. I think if you have the right attitude for you to learn, that is no
absolutely.
It's not a big deal.
So hire for attitude and train for skills.
Brilliant line. All you recruiters out there or would-be recruiters, please memorize this line. I think it's the best. It'll take you places.
Yeah.
My next question, ma'am, who's been the greatest influence on you?
My mother.
I think
my mother.
There's an old saying, because they could have God everywhere, he made mothers, right? I think they are always the silent heroes in a lot of our lives.
Absolutely. And they we are what we are because of the strong mothers we have.
Absolutely.
And definitely, you know, a lot. Lot of influence in my life, the person I am, and the courage which I've got has been from my mother. And of course, my father, I come from an army background, and my father has been a part of some wars and all.
He was also
in the Kargil war and all of that. So that kind of courage, you know, and confidence comes from the upbringing I've had from my parents. But my influencer is my mom.
Lovely. Definitely. Lovely, ma'am. My next question, ma'am, what's the best professional advice you've ever been given? Somebody's given you that advice.
I've received lots of, there are free advices available all over the place. The best advice which I have professionally, received from one of my CHROs, in fact, a couple of years back is, just remain apolitical. Don't belong to any groups. So those of you who are watching my interview, and some of you would be joining corporates, some of you are already in the corporates, you would know that in the corporates, there are different groups and gangs of people, like this party and that party, just like anywhere in the world.
True.
So the best thing is not to belong to a particular group and just remain neutral and that's about it. So that's the advice, one of my bosses gave to me, and I've lived by this. And as a result, I've been away from a lot of politics, which happen at work. And that has ensured my, calm and peace of mind.
And the smiling face that you have, because office politics, man, can ruin
you. Yes.
If you fall in the wrong
away from it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You never know when you get used as a pawn, because you would feel that you're a pawn group. I think people get used like a pawn and they would not even know and then get killed. So I think staying apolitical is the place to be, because then you're not party to one and you have your neutral standing. And honestly, you are expected for that, because if you have the courage out alone and not be a part of team A or team B and still voice your opinion, I think that exuberates a lot of courage, which not many people have. So I think
absolutely. Yeah.
Perfect. Next question, ma'am. Who is your favorite sports person?
I'm not really too much into sports.
It's okay to not even have one. That's absolutely fine.
Yeah. So my answer to this would be really nobody.
Fair enough. Again, like I said,
that's an honest answer.
I was about to say that honesty has become such a rare commodity these days.
Yeah.
To fit in, you could have said maybe Sachin or Dhoni because cricket and India. But this, you are actually reiterating the fact that you are apolitical, you stand for what you are. And I think that's taken you places, ma'am. You could have easily been a part of the gang and said, "Arey, Dhoni, everyone knows the name, right?"
Yeah, exactly.
I would have asked you his birth date to cross check, but I think the fact that you're honest is incredible, ma'am. Thanks.
Thank you.
My next question, ma'am, your favorite song?
My favorite song, Dilbar Mere.
Dilbar Mere. That's a nice song, ma'am.
So this is my son plays guitar and so my son is in class 10th now and he plays lovely guitar and he plays this song really well.
Wow.
So once he started playing it on the guitar, I liked it more. So it is a Rajesh Khanna song and it's a lovely old number.
Absolutely. And the fact that your son plays it on the guitar, I think makes the song even more precious to you. So
yeah, it's really precious to me.
Yeah.
It's my life.
Oh yes, of course. I was thinking that would be your go-to song because the way you've led your life, that song completely is embodiment of what you are. So
yeah, I love it. Absolutely.
Perfect. That holds true. My next question, ma'am, your favorite movie?
There have been lots of my favorite movies. I generally like comedy and sometimes romantic movies. So I really can't pinpoint that this is my favorite movies. There are certain genres I like. So it is the comedies which
you like comedy and romantic movies more. Okay.
Yeah, more. So first is comedy and then the romantic. But there's nothing I can label as this is my favorite and I would want to watch it again and again. But something like Golmaal and all. Yeah.
If I mix the two, you like comedy and romantic. A lot of people's love life is like a romantic comedy, right? Because there's a lot of that genre will also be interesting for you. So
that will be very interesting. Yeah, yeah. So I like to go to the movie hall and watch the movie and
correct.
Really, I don't like to on the TV or on the Netflix or
Fair.
Because I want to be in a space where I'm laughing and laughing all the time right. When I'm in the theater and I'm in another world. So indeed. That's why I don't want to watch dramas and serials and horror stuff.
They do say laughter is the best medicine. So I think you're absolutely living with that. Great, ma'am. True. My next question, the most fun moment at work.
So there have been lots of, in my entire career of 20 years, there's been lots of fun moments at work, but the best ones have been, when as a team, we have achieved something really brilliant in a short span of time. And we are absolutely, happy, so happy about it. And we are celebrating, we're going out to party. So for me, we have team targets and we ensure that whenever we achieve those targets, we go out for lunches and we go out for parties.
Nice.
And those are the times when we bond very well as a team together. And we have another benchmark or another target for us to achieve. So those are real happy, fun moments, which I've always remembered from my past jobs also. And my colleagues and teammates have always remembered because we are out there at work for a reason. We are not just there to just have fun. So if you're able to meet our targets, we're able to achieve something really great for the organization. And as a human resource function, it is the employees who matter the most to us.
Absolutely.
So if we are able to do something great for them and it gives us happiness is what makes our life fun. So that's what it is.
To all those listeners who want a brilliant workplace and some fun, you have to, whose team you have to join, right?
Absolutely.
A tough taskmaster will work, organized, get you to achieve your targets, but then also celebrate. So it's not just about the whip. It's also about celebrating the
team. And rewarding. Yeah.
Exactly. I think that's very critical. A lot of leaders miss that out, man. They'll get you to work and achieve all the targets and then enjoy accolades all by themselves. I think that happens a lot. I think this is an interesting learning to take away that, of course, you work as a team, you're a family, but when you also succeed, you should celebrate like a family, not enjoy the accolades by yourself. It should be split between the entire team member equally because they've all they've all contributed, right? It's not just you.
Yeah.
You, of course, guided them, but they've done a lot of work. So,
yes,
just
yes.
Take
in fact, they have done more
celebrate.
Work.
Exactly. Yeah. So, it's good to celebrate also, because then if tomorrow you also are also a little strict on them, they know it is for a good cause. And it's not just
yes.
because to achieve a target, because when you achieve, you also celebrate. But when you don't work well, you have the right, in a rightful manner, to also tell them where they are wrong. So I think accept it with open hearts, right? Because they know it's for their good.
They know. Exactly.
Yeah.
That's what it is.
Perfect. My next question, ma'am. What's the best professional advice you have ever given to someone?
My mantra, most of my working life in HR has been into recruitment. So the best professional advice I've given to my team members who have reported to me and who have learned how to interview from me has been the same thing. Hire for attitude and train for skills. Because
wow.
you are not going to be, because once you do this right, once you hire the right person in your organization, you are doing absolutely fantastic work, not only for the organization, but also for the person you've hired. So there are people
right.
I would have hired in, you know, in the year 2000. When I was with G, I was in G in the year 2000, and they still remember me, you know, as an interview. Once I was in a mall, and this person just met me, and I was at the food court, and he said, "Ma'am, you interviewed me and you hired me," and I was blown. I was like, "Oh my God, this is like 20 years back. This person still remembers you."
Wow.
And then this person has done very well for himself at work. So people you hire, when they
yeah.
you are the right person, they end up doing very well for themselves. You know, I feel really proud of myself then. And also when they have great contribution towards the organization,
yeah.
you know, we are as human resource professionals playing a very important life, role in the
role.
Lives of not only
yeah.
the people we hire, but also for the entire organization. It's us who are creating the entire organization, because people are the organization.
Absolutely.
So my advice to professional advice to everybody has been one, hire for attitude, train for skills. And again, be apolitical. Don't belong to any teams, team A
Correct.
Or team B. Remain and do not get into politics. So the advice for me has been the advice for others.
Lovely, lovely. So what you take as personal advice is what you give. I think that's being absolutely transparent, because it's worked for you. Why
yeah.
help this work for others?
Exactly. That's what I always think. Because
it's
worked very well for me.
Absolutely.
Why shouldn't it work for somebody else?
Absolutely.
Yeah. And it has.
Lovely, lovely. My last question to you, your advice to younger employees or younger people joining colleges, just the younger lot, what's your advice for them?
So my advice for them is to remain focused. Life is not a bed of roses. There are going to be challenges in your career and in your life. And learning from my own experience, you know, when, you know, I started my corporate career with a great organization and worked for 6 years, and nobody had thought that something like this would happen to me. And I became a housewife. So imagine, you know, I left my job, I
yeah.
was a housewife, and my husband was a pilot in the same airline now I'm working with. And I thought that I'm happy being at home, and this happened, and this unfortunate devastation happened
yeah.
in our lives. And I had to bounce back, I had to gather all the courage, and you know, and then I just. And it's only you who will matter. So stop.
Absolutely.
There will be people who will emotionally help you. There will be people who will help you mentally. But finally, it's you who has to gather all the shattered pieces in your life.
Absolutely.
And have that positive attitude and completely look ahead. Stop cribbing, because cribbing, I feel, gets lots of negativity in your lives. Disassociate with people who bring negativity in your lives. That's extremely important, because we have all kinds of people in our arena, right? So it's important to know who is not the right person for you and who is the right person. Completely stay focused. Have your goals
nice.
In place. Very important. Write them down. You should have your goals in place that by so-and-so time and by so-and-so age, I want to do this. And go through them again and again. And doesn't matter if you're not able to achieve those goals, because there are times, and especially in this uncertain pandemic situation, all of us have had our goals, but we're not, you know, career-wise, financial goals,
yeah.
we're not able to achieve those goals. So that's fine, because there are so many other circumstances and reasons why we're not able to meet our goals, but still keep on continuing. Never give up. Never,
never
ever give up. always have, you know, there could be 100 excuses for not doing something, but one reason for doing something.
Yeah.
So, you know, you just have, you should have that one reason for, you know, for you to keep on going and keep on going and going and not look back. Because like I said, winter always turns into spring. It has never happened that, you know, a dark cloud will always remain there. It will pass away and there will be sunshine. So don't get disheartened. Don't get demotivated by what's happening around the world. There are people who in this situation may not be having jobs right now. There will be people who will be passing out from colleges and will be sitting at home for a year or more, maybe more than that. Try different passions, not necessarily a corporate job, but be passionate about whatever you do. There's so many other ways of leading a very fulfilled, happy life. So that's my advice to everybody. And then I'm always there. People can connect with me over chat and, you know, and we can all be together to make our life journeys very beautiful.
In fact, I read this somewhere, ma'am, worrying is like a rocking chair. It keeps you in that loop, but never takes you anywhere. So
absolutely. So correct.
Yeah. And to your point, the whole purpose of this podcast is, ma'am, so that A, people know who you are, they know your persona, they know your likes and dislikes. So it makes it easier for us to approach you now. And yes, it's an open offer, guys, minus free SpiceJet tickets, anything else that you want from ma'am, mentorship, guidance, it's right there. And you can see her personality. She's willing. It is just for us to approach. And the biggest learning out of this chat that I've had with you, ma'am, is that it's essential to have nerves of steel. You have ups and downs. The down that you had was a down that can completely down and out people, and they can never come out of it.
Yeah.
Last time you bounced back, you took a job with a 7-year break also, and now you are where you are. I think it speaks volumes. No MBA school can teach us this grit, this resilience. And why look out on YouTube for such inspiration when we have inspiration within our families? People like you, I think, will inspire for generations to come in AIMK fraternity. Also seniors, because there would be some seniors going through a tough phase because of COVID, because of current circumstances. It's only good to see that there is a positive side that's going to come. Sometimes it could take slightly longer. Sometimes it comes immediately. But you have to hang in there. Like I said, have nerves of steel. And you have a life example here with ma'am, where if at all you feel low, just give her a call. I think 30 seconds of chat with her, I've been privileged to talk to her for almost 20 minutes. I'm feeling elated. I think 30 seconds with her also will take you to a notch higher. So
thank you so much,
ma'am. Thank you for your time. Really appreciate this, ma'am.
Thank you so much, Vikramjeet. You've been great. Thank you.
Thank you.
Vikramjeet, you've been great. Thank you.
Thank you.